Hallelujah, brothers and sisters and brothers. I am Reverend Eustace Pringle. This is the 10-minute prayer hour. And folks, I am coming into your homes tonight with dark, dark tidings about the world. Brothers and sisters and brothers, I turned on my television viewer tonight and I saw that they were transmitting a cartoon animation for children themed after Halloween. Now, I am an open-minded man. I am a free thinker. At last year's Christmas caroling fundraiser, several of the parishioners sang a song that included the lyric, "Gay Apparel," and I did not object. But I was watching this program and I found that I was experiencing alarm. I was experiencing chagrin. I was experiencing concern for America's child soul. I want to tell you about this cartoon animation for children with the title, It's the Great Pumpkin, Charles Brown. Folks, I am told this has been transmitted for over 50 years. I have never partaken of it before. Folks, this is a satanic program. This is a program in which a small child indulges in the yearly worship of a pagan idol made from a pumpkin. And he lures a younger and more impressionable girl child to commit this idolatry with him. This is a program in which many children anticipate their own deaths by dressing as ghosts. This is a program in which some kind of dog, it's a small dog, I think, a terrier, perhaps, possibly a kind of spaniel, maybe a Yorkie or a Sheltie. My brother-in-law breeds Shelties. They have beautiful coats, magnificent creatures. It could possibly be as large as some kind of collie or shepherd. It is, in any case, a canine person of some sort who, in the course of this program, he impersonates a serviceman, which is a federal crime. Now, the thing I find most interesting about this cartoon animation for children is it first transmitted in the year 1966, which is also the year of the founding of a certain church in San Francisco. I will not say the name. And that church was founded by a man who had shaved his head from all his hairs. And you will notice also that the young child on the television program, Charles Brown, has also none. And you will see a certain resemblance between them that I do not think is accidental. When we first turn on this cartoon animation for children, we see two children. One of them is dressed in red in imitation of the Lord. The other one, this one, is a girl child. She wears blue, reminiscent of the Holy Virgin. And there is a song playing that sounds to me very much like the heavy metal musics. And you will see that the very first thing that this child does is eat an apple. Folks, he eats an apple. There's an apple. When the Luciferian Illuminati agenda handed down by the mainstream media in this way is so explicit, and the folks in the cities who decide these things in places like New York and Gatman and Doddsville, and other modern-day Sodoms like Winstonville and Slate Springs, when they make it so obvious and so easy for the New World, eating windfall apples, that is not high-quality produce for a growing child. The nutrients... before it's ripe. And so that's not good either. That is a problem. That is a concern as well. And if you continue watching these children, they walk through a pile of fallen leaves, which of course represents our fallen world, our world of corruption and depredation. And you will see they are rejoiceful. And they walk right here into some kind of garden. But folks, this is not the garden of paradise. This is not the garden of the Lord from which they are selecting there. I think it's a melon that they take. This is the garden of sin. This is Satan's garden that now these children are playing in. And that really is the nature of Halloween, folks. This is a cartoon of intolerance. This is a cartoon of indiscretion. This is a cartoon of impiety. And I happen to think that this is why we're seeing these radical socialists, these far-left Marxist extremists and satanic anarchist collectivists like Joe Biden and that Cleopatra Harris. This is where it starts. The agenda begins on the television and on the Halloweens, and it ends with forcing our children to urinate alongside globalist drag queens at the public library. And that is why we must take a stand. We must take a stand against Charles Brown and the Great Pumpkin and the naked paganism that it represents. This media agenda of dogs and witchcraft, that is not the America our founders left for us. Our librarian tells me that this cartoon animation for children was created by a man called Charles Schultz. And I don't know what kind of witch or druid or vegan he is, but the occult agenda at work in his cartooning, Two Thessalonians talks about the son of perdition, the man of sin, and that son of perdition, that is Charles Brown. That is, he is an antichrist figure on the television. And 2 Thessalonians tells us, let no man deceive you by any means. And let us make clear that any means includes cartoon pumpkins. Do not think that there is a special exception written in there for that, for dogs wearing goggles. There's not. It's universal. There's nothing scribbled at the back of the book on the back of the last page. It's all in there, folks, just so we're clear. Now, folks, they're signaling me that we're out of time, so please have a prayerful day, and remember that it is up to each of us to take the sin out of common sense.